just get through to the final safely and control the race in the front.
How did you like your sensation?
Oh, it's pretty exciting. I have a lot of fans in the stands right now and a lot of close supporters that have been on this journey with me for a long time. They finally get to see me race at home, so it's really special.
And to, you know, you always said that it's a stressful process. Is it still stressful?
Sure. I mean, my spot's still on the line. I haven't booked my ticket to London yet until I'm top three tomorrow. So it is stressful because it's still a process. Nothing's guaranteed in this sport.
And what's the plan?
Win. I want to be on the podium.
More pressure with the fans or better feeling?
No, it's better. It's an extra adrenaline boost.
That's it.
Yeah.
That's what you want.
Of course.
When's the last time you went through the first lap in 62 seconds in a race?
I think we did last year, actually, in the heats. To be honest, I'm not sure.
Was it a bit uncomfortable going out at that pace where you're going at sub-60 most of these races?
No, when you're so focused on the plan, you don't really focus on what the split is at that point. I mean, it's about feeling good and being able to respond.
Were you at all nervous, maybe leading it to the last 100 meters and trying to pull away at all?
No, I think I was looking at the start list, and I'm one of the oldest people on the start line now, so I think I've had a few races under my belt, and I can remain calm and relaxed.
What are you going to do between now and the finals?
I'm going to go home and eat, get a massage, and sleep. I'll be back here tomorrow.
Do you have the whole Bishop plan out here?
Yeah, plus some. All of Eganville, Ottawa Valley. There's a lot of people here. I don't know if I'll be able to see them tonight, but certainly tomorrow after the final.
Thanks.